Welcome to SystemVue. In this tutorial, we're going to look at X-parameter models in system-level design. For this, we're going to use the SystemVue core environment and the RF system design kit. The first question you may ask are, what are X-parameters? They're a new nonlinear analog model that's formulated in the frequency domain. If you've heard of S-parameters, they're a superset of S-parameters in that they create harmonics. They can be either measurement or simulation based. And the benefit of using either of these approaches is that you can take an architectural design that's based sort of on behavioral models and bring in implementation based into your system level design. So you may have heard them for X-parameters for circuit designers, but for system level designers there's a little bit different benefit to these. And if you'd like to know more about X-parameters themselves, we encourage you to go to this Agilent website of agilent.com/find/esoth-x-parameters. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make a circuit that has an X-parameter. So I go to my RF design catalog and I type in an X and search for things with X, and I find an X-parameter component. When I place it, notice that it has no ports. The instantiation comes from the information contained inside the X-parameter file. This one's been exported from the ADS platform. When I go to the Details tab, I can see how many ports it has, the number of independent variables, and the sweep ranges that are embedded in this. So, for example, this has a DC pin that is expecting 10 volts. It's also been characterized in a two-tone sense at 1 gigahertz and 1.2 gigahertz. So now that I've placed this part, I can finish wiring this. I have a DC voltage supply and an output port. If I'd like to create other analog matching or bias components and combine multiple nonlinear devices in this one circuit, I can run, in fact, a captive analog simulator that combines all these effects and rolls them up to the system level. Now, SpectraSys has not formally had this capability, so in SpectraSys, there is now a new component called a circuit link. When I place a circuit link into a SpectraSys system, in this case the system is only a source and an output, when I place this, I see the circuit link parameter. I choose which analog circuit I'm going to put in here. This is not a general purpose analog co-simulation. However, this particular controller allows me to set up the number of tones in a and convergence criteria for the analog simulator that's underneath. I can now hook this into my SpectraSys circuit. This will characterize that analog subcircuit, bring this, the characteristics up to the system level, so that when I run my system analysis, which I've already established, it runs the SpectraSys simulator to get me the RF system response for this whole system. So I'm going to assume that you know how to use SpectraSys. That's detailed elsewhere in this video set. And with SpectraSys, I'm able to calculate different system level budget analyses and intermods and spurs for this particular video system. So let's go back to our information and summarize. For system architects, X-parameters are versatile and transportable. They give more detail than a normal power transfer curve or a P2D model. So those have power dependence and sometimes frequency dependence, but X-parameters actually include complex loading, bias dependence, harmonics, and these things all show up in the SpectraSys analysis. Another benefit is that you can now communicate with design flows and measurements outside of this platform and bring implementation data here. And it just absolutely blows away spreadsheet type models for RF analysis. Okay, the next step is to bring this up to the true system level. And for this, we're going to take this QPSK modulation circuit, we will take our RF subnetwork and drag and drop it off the workspace tree using RF link and put it into our block diagram. Notice that it has instantiated this, and it will characterize our SpectraSys frequency domain circuit for its power and frequency dependence in the modulation bandwidth. I'm now at the data flow level, and when I simulate, I will look at the modulated output on a vector signal analyzer. So let's do that now. When I look at the result, I can see the EVM. These are two vector signal analyzer measurements. One has an EVM of about 0.3 or 0.4%. The other has an EVM of about 11%. And I'm looking before and after this RF cascaded nonlinear component. So to summarize, X parameter usage for baseband and system level physical layer communications designers, you know, the X parameters come from real implementations. They come from either a circuit simulator extraction, for example, in the Agilent ADS platform, or from real nonlinear vector network analyzer measurements. So they have a lot of accuracy benefits over pure math models that you may be using for RF parts. And you don't, even though I used it, I don't really need to understand or have the RF tools or libraries that are associated with that RF part. I can just take that RF part and just use it in a baseband or system level design. So an RF designer may have created that circuit, but you as a baseband or system level designer can simply use it, and this lets both departments or organizations within your design team share communication tools throughout the design process and continue to build baseband architectures that take into account realistic RF impairments. So it's a versatile format. It's envelope-based using this RF link technology, and because it runs directly at the data flow level, you can still get RF accurate results at a very fast simulation rate. If you'd like to know more about X parameters, once again, go to agilent.com, find ESOF-X parameters, and you'll find many tutorial videos on X parameters. Thanks very much.